Something with foam came to me today from eBay. Shall we open it up and see what it is? Okay. Take the top off. See, they packed it real nice like. And this, let me pull it closer to me. Let me turn it around for you. Oh, this goes wrong. This way. This is an RCA that has an old-fashioned record button, stop and play. And I'm going to take it out of its, it's got a, it's a beautiful color, olive green. One of my favorite colors, by the way. And here it comes with one of those old-fashioned earplugs. And some, which is very unusual, tapes. These tapes were here. Never seen any like this before. Have no idea, but I'm sure they're good tapes. But what's inside of here is actually an RCA cassette tape. And the door opens up. Just took it out of the box, you know? Okay, and it has no window. And it comes with directions and all of that. See? Nice set of directions to tell you what everything is at, where's everything. And there's the cassette up, right here up here where you push the cassette. That gets it out of there. But it has no plug for electricity. Not one single plug. It's all, it has a cassette up, a microphone, a remote, auxiliary, and a speaker out. Okay? And then it has a volume control button. And then it has that all-in-one. This is very rare, and I got it for $3. Off eBay. Nobody bid it on this, okay? I was the sole bidder, and quite frankly, I forgot I even bid it. And they had to remind me to pay them. And that's when they send it, and it got here in 2 days. And this came out of here. This is the remote. Okay, let me unzip in the remote. I got one hammer, but it's beautiful. Look at that beautiful piece of machinery. Okay, let me get it out of here. Yes, my channel is basically a tech channel. I do all kinds of things that's technical. Okay, let's see if I can undo this. Okay. Now here is the microphone. Let me slip this baby in. And let me open this up and let you see what's going on. Maybe it'll let me do that. Okay. And this is the microphone, the RCA microphone. It actually came with the dynamic microphone. DM59. You know, and here is the RCA cassette. Now let's see when I push play what happens. Whoop. Okay, now.
We got a RCA. Let me open the manual. Let me look at the manual. It actually came with the manual and the instructions. And all, I got it off eBay for, you won't believe this crazy amount, for $3. But shipping and handle was $14. I mean, it got here in 2 days. And I mean, it was fast shipping, and it's a olive color green, which I love, by the way. And It comes with its own original microphone, and it also came with complimentary tapes here. Very old RCA tapes. I mean, it's just incredible. And the earpiece, and I'm going to start with this little demo for you. And as you know, I've been very busy doing studio work and music work, and then the work that I do to get by, So I'm, juggling a lot of coals on fire right now, but I'm still, you can best believe if I got something on there, a lot of work went into anything I did. And it's funny that this thing would come in olive green, since I'm doing this green screen effect. And also I do the TV effect. You can also do it with your television set. If you have like a I would say a 27-inch or 32-inch, you can do it. But anything smaller than a 27-inch, I wouldn't advise it. You can actually use the blue screen, and then you have to download some software. They have several programs that are out there on the internet for green screen that are free. Of course, there's tons and tons of ones you could buy. You can buy a whole freaking studio kit if you're willing to spend like $500, that is. But you can get it done. Basically just going to the store and getting yourself some, it's kind of, the color green you need is kind of like a lime green, a true green, no funny looking green, it won't work. It's got to be really a true green, and it tends to go for like a light color lime green, and that's what I'm thinking, because that's what I'm using, and it does work really perfect. And you need lights. You need even lighting. If you have a lighter, you have to have wherever your studio. You know the way you do a studio. You light one, put one light on one side, and put one light on the other side, and put one light, if you can, in back of the screen, and then you put a floodlight in the front. That's a lot of lights, right? But I don't do all that. I use fluorescent lights. Right from the top of the ceiling. You can use your top lights. And just to give you a little secret, I think people have you buying all these freaking lights to make money. But if you have a good type top ceiling light and it's beaming down into your TV set, that will do it. And if you by chance have a light that a floodlight going head on with it for the subject would be great. I wind up telling you anyway how to do this. It takes a little work, and you will not get it on the first time, I guarantee you. And just getting all that set up is just the beginning. Then you've got to actually get on your computer and make all this stuff work. That is when it really becomes real tricky-dicky. Okay, so this is a beautiful RCA. It's a very old looking one. I can't imagine. It doesn't have a plug. It doesn't have an AC plug. I'm using 4C batteries on this here RCA, and I got the thing here. I think model number is JW006. That is the model number. This was printed in Japan, it says here. So I think that's about enough, and I'm going to stop it with this remote.
Okay, we want to hear what I was done originally on here. That's what was originally on the tape, but I don't know what's on there, and I don't want them zapping this here freaking thing. Okay. It does have a problem. Put this on. It rewinds real freaking slow. But I think to remedy that, like I said, I just took it out of the box and I got a spray. I was gonna give you a music test, but I'm up to 10 minutes. Gotta go.